Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning channel. In the previous video, you learnt about the general application of timeline effects in the effects environment. So you have multiple ways of applying them, reorganizing multiple timeline effects, and deleting them if necessary. This video will focus specifically on copying timeline effects between multiple segments and the various ways in doing so. This video is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. Now you are looking at a selected segment in the effects environment, and I've already applied multiple timeline effects to develop the final look of the shot. Looking at the effects pipeline, the shot was graded with the master grade in the image timeline effects, a matchbox bloom shader was added next, followed by a repo using 2D transform, and finally, the image has a burn-in letterbox applied. So we have the four timeline effects in that order, and it's currently only local to this segment. Now in terms of copy effects between segments, you have the traditional copy and paste method, or the gestural drag and drop method. Both methods are selection based, so make sure that you choose what you want to copy and decide where to copy it. For example, let's do the copy and paste method first. So select or multi-select the timeline effects you wish to copy. This can be done by either clicking the timeline effects in the effects pipeline or in the storyboard thumbnail. You can use Control to perform a multi-selection. Now either using the contextual menu or pressing Control C, you can copy the selection. Next, you select or multi-select the thumbnails with Control and paste the timeline effects either with the contextual menu or press Alt-V. Now with the timeline effects applied to the selected segment, you can leave it as it is or select a timeline effects and make an adjustment. So we'll adjust this 2D transform to show more of the top of the frame. Now let's look at the drag and drop method, as it is slightly different to copy and paste. Once again, I go back to the original segment with the timeline effects. Now let's say you have other shots that you want to apply the same look. So keeping the shot still selected, use either Control or Shift to select the thumbnails in the storyboard. So the yellow outline is your primary selection, and the orange outline is the secondary selection. As an extra tip, you can use filtering, sorting, and searching to isolate the specific shots you want to affect. These tools are covered in greater depth in previous videos. Now select one or multiple timeline effects in the effects pipeline or the storyboard thumbnail. To copy the selected timeline effects in a gestural way, just drag them off the effects bar or the storyboard thumbnail and drop them onto the secondary selection. You can now tweak each shot or leave them as they are. Now because you can drag and drop from either the effects pipeline or storyboard reel, you can hide one or the other and work with whatever means suits you. So it's relatively straightforward to create timeline effects and copy them to multiple shots across your sequence. Please bear in mind that if you copy a timeline effects to a segment already containing the same one, it will be overwritten. Any different timeline effects will simply be added to the effects pipeline. I also wanted to add that it is possible to copy the image selectives between segments, but that will be covered in the videos specific to the image timeline effects. Now, since you can copy timeline effects, whether you're doing any grading or VFX tasks, it is also possible to create your own set of presets that you can use in this sequence or repurpose for other productions. You'll cover all of that in the next video. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2019. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.